I'm your digital craftsman in Forale, and I will show you what you can do in this exciting decentralized financial world of Bancor. Bancor is a decentralized trading platform where you can trade almost all Ethereum-based cryptos. The cool thing is you don't need any permissions or any personal requirements. Bancor is completely decentralized and open source. But you can do even more than trading with Bancor. With Bancor, you can build a passive income. That means you can send your cryptos to work, or you can actively shape the future of Bancor. It is truly a one-stop DeFi solution for you. I know that sounds like a quite long journey and you feel probably a little bit overwhelmed, but hopefully also a little bit curious. Then this tutorial is the right place to start your journey. In short video tutorials, we will cover all the things you can do with Bancor and even a little bit more, so that you will have a nice overview of all DeFi related topics. To enter Bancor, let's click here on Trade. On the first site, if you are already familiar with online banking apps or websites, then you will quickly find your way around. I mean, the whole app is relatively simple and very easy to navigate, and quite similar to like the most banking apps. So on the left side, you can see the navigation bar. Here you can get a good overview of what's possible with Bancor. I know it looks a lot, but don't worry. I mean, we will have a look at every single point in this tutorial series. The first thing you should do is to create a bookmark in your browser. That way you will always get to this page without having to retype the website, and you can always be sure to land on the correct page. In the middle you can see the swap interface, and if you check the left side, oh yes, we are at the swap page. We will use the swap interface in the next video, but for today it's completely fine that we know what this box is. On the top right corner, you have the options bar. Here you can find an overview for all communications around Bancor, like social media links, Telegram groups, or the Twitter account. The Telegram group is really helpful and informative. I mean, the whole community around Bancor is so special that I will dedicate a full section of the tutorial just to show you how and what is possible as a community member. The gear gives you the possibility to use Bancor in other languages, for example, like in German. But I would recommend you just to leave the language in English. I mean, it's all new anyway, so, and the main language on social media channels is English. And actually, all the dApps and all the blockchain space is still in English. You probably already know the bell from other apps. It shows you personal notifications, for example, if you have made a trade. And it's really, really useful. And then we have it, the Connect Wallet button, our first interaction with Bancor and your entry to the exciting DeFi world with Bancor. Because in order to do anything with a DeFi protocol or dApp, you have to connect your wallet. You only need your wallet, no address, no names, no registration. No one needs permission to use Bancor, because Bancor is for everyone. Okay, let's go. Let's connect your wallet to Bancor. Bancor allows or supports the most popular wallets out there, like MetaMask, which is a browser plugin, the Coinbase Wallet, which is a wallet from Coinbase, hardware wallets like Trezor or Ledger, and Wallet Connect. Today, I will show you how to connect Bancor with MetaMask, the Coinbase Wallet, and with Argent, a super cool smartphone wallet. If you don't have a wallet, I can recommend these videos, and you will find the links in the description as well. So let's start with MetaMask, a browser plugin. Press Connect Wallet. Select MetaMask. Now MetaMask should open and I have to enter my wallet password, and then I can confirm that I want to connect. You see that you are logged in because the Connect Wallet button has changed and is showing your wallet address. To log out, simply press it again and you're logged out. Okay, let's continue with the Coinbase wallet. You just open your wallet app on your smartphone and press on this QR code button. Then you can simply scan the code and you're connected to Bancor. Okay, one more. So let's go out again. Well, let's log out again. And now the last one with Argent. Here it is the same like the Coinbase wallet, but I have to select the Wallet Connect button. Open Argent, select QR code symbol and scan. And here we are. We are connected. Awesome. For the tutorial series, I will use the MetaMask wallet because in general, all steps are the same for different wallets, and it's for me the most easy to use a wallet within my browser. So great. I'm connected and hopefully you are too. Now we are ready to make an exchange or token swap. It is necessary for you that you already have some cryptos on Ethereum to cover the transaction cost, because for every action on the Ethereum blockchain, you need to pay a small fee in Ethereum. But luckily, I'm pretty sure you know what I'm gonna say, you can buy some on Bancor. I really hope you enjoyed this video and you are really curious for our next steps with Bancor. See you on the next one for your first token swap on Bancor.